This business is a digital marketing business. It's called KW Digital. It used to be the marketing department of MGA Controls, which is an engineering business. And Rachel and I grew it into about 16 or 17 people strong. And then we made it independent, so it now services the rest of the control and the process industry. We're different from most other digital marketing agencies insofar as we have an intimate knowledge of the products in this specific market. So we develop websites, we look after search engine optimization, we do the Google pay-per-click, we write the content using writers who understand the products they're writing about. KW Digital, as I said, was formerly the marketing department of MGA Control, so that team occupied the same building as MGA Controls, and we pushed them upstairs to the first floor, and as they grew and grew in numbers, they were bulging at the seams, basically. We ran out of desks, there was nowhere else to put them, and it became pretty evident to us about 12 months ago that we needed to have some new premises, and that's why we moved. I've worked with Nexus before, but in this instance, when I looked at the project, there's the pre-contract phase and the post-contract phase, and during the pre-contract phase, my primary concerns at that stage would be office design, layout, and of course budget, whereas in the post-contract phase, I'm more concerned about quality and on-time delivery. 8 or 9 years ago, I converted one of these buildings and took on the role of project manager myself. It was a lot of work, it was very time consuming, and I found it would be almost impossible to find that time whilst I'm trying to run a business as managing director. I found it a much more efficient use of time to work with a contracting company that I could trust, that I had a good relationship with, and that I knew would take the strain in delivering my build to time and to cost, and that worked really well. As a client, and indeed as a landlord, I would say that whilst I'm very mindful of my legal obligations under the Health and Safety Executive for the health and well-being of any workers on site, I would be the first to hold my hand up and say I'm not fully aware of all the intimate details that are required within that. For me, it worked very well to be able to hand over that responsibility to Matthew Barnes as my principal designer, and in doing that, Matt was taking responsibility on my behalf for the health and safety of the workers on the site. I had a look at the method statements, I had a look at the procedures, I had a look at the health and safety operation that was taking place on site, and I was very satisfied and happy that it was being done properly and professionally. I sat down with Matt Barnes, we played around with certain CAD drawings, we looked at the size of the departments, we looked at how we would have some isolation for the development team, some quiet thinking time, some creative thinking space, some breakout areas within the business for the team to relax and so on. And so by sitting with Matt, who was very accommodating, I must say, we came up with what we considered to be the perfect design. In terms of the drawings, defining the scope of works, the plumbing, the electrical, the whole layout, the quality of the documentation was superb. It was easy for a layperson to understand. And if ever I had any difficulties, it was just a case of picking up the phone, and lo and behold, a revised drawing appeared in my email, usually within 24, 48 hours. And that was a very, very straightforward process. Working with the Nexus team on site was very, very easy. I would even say it was an enjoyable experience because Matt Ayres is a very, very easy guy to get on with. We had a great relationship. We worked together on a previous project. I was able to relax completely in the knowledge that Matty would give me a quality solution. Nothing was too much trouble for him. And I think the culture of the organisation, it's endemic within how the company works, that they want to deliver a good solution. So Matty was just bought into that culture all the way through the process, and it worked very well. We have growth plans for the business. We expect to be doubling in turnover over the next 2 or 3 years. That will mean a considerable increase in staff numbers. The capacity that this building gives us is, I think, 32 with existing desks. So it will allow us to remain in this location for the next 2 or 3 years, and by which time I think we'll be looking at maybe opening another office, maybe in another city. So it gives us a really nice working environment. I think more importantly, or just as importantly, when we invite clients to our premises, your premises becomes your showpiece. It says a lot about your image, it says a lot about who you are to your client, and it's very important to us that we have a very high quality building, a building that leaves a lasting impression with the client, and I think we've achieved that. The quality of the work at the end of the day is second to none. I can't say how happy I am with how the project has turned out. We have a building that we're very proud of, and at the end of the day, I would say for the second time in a couple of years, we're a very, very happy customer with the work of Nexus. If and when I move on to my next building refurbishment, Nexus will be the first people that I speak to, and I would not hesitate in recommending Nexus to anyone else who I know looking to convert a building.